treatment options for COVID-19 have been quite limited, but there's another alternative at the forefront.
The pandemic has been a learning experience for everyone, making people more familiar with medical terms like plasma, which has made news headlines. But what exactly is it? And what does it have to do with COVID-19? Well, plasma plays a critical role in the body and is used to treat disease. When people get sick, the body creates antibodies within plasma to help fight the illness, which can then be used to help other people recover. The FDA recently issued an emergency authorization to treat hospitalized COVID-19 patients by using plasma from recovered patients. But clinical trials are still ongoing, and the questions remain. Could plasma from people who recovered from COVID-19 be used to prevent serious illness in others and protect people before they even get sick?
Now, my first guest is one of the leaders of the COVID-19 plasma clinical trial at Johns Hopkins University. His name is Dr. Shoham. Hey, Dr. Shoham, how are you?
Hi.
Let's explain to the viewers about plasma. What exactly is plasma and where is it?
So plasma is about 55% of the blood, and people that donate blood, we can separate the red cells and the platelets and the plasma from each other, give them back the red cells and the platelets, and then keep the plasma that then we can use for medical purposes and then also for this particular research study.
Sure. So inside the plasma, the reason why we want to use it is because we will find the antibodies to the virus, correct?
Correct. So people that have survived coronavirus can make high levels of antibodies that are protective against coronavirus. And the studies that we're doing are to give people plasma that has that high level of antibody to see if we can prevent infection from happening in the first place or treat infections that has already happened to stop it in its tracks.
So the way the trial is broken down is this. If someone has had COVID and have a positive test, you'll put them into the trial, and they may get one of two things. They may get the plasma from someone who had COVID, so it has the antibody, so they have antibody plasma, or they may get plasma from someone who has not had COVID in the past, so that would just be regular plasma without the antibodies.
Exactly. So it's two trials that are, or two parts of one large trial. One is to prevent infection from happening in the first place, and the second one is to take people that already have infection and see if we can stop it in its track. And it's a randomized control trial, which means that half of the patients will get plasma that has high antibody levels, and the other half will get regular plasma. And I don't know what they're going to get. They don't know what they're going to get. And in the end, we'll find out what groups got what, and we'll see if people progress to developing an infection in the case of the prevention or progressing with their infection in the case of people that already have infection. And then we can find out if this stuff works.
Now, you say in the end. So how long will this trial last?
Once you're in the trial, we follow people for 90 days. Most of the action is probably going to happen in the first few weeks as to whether they progress from the infection or develop an infection. But we do follow people for 90 days to make sure that everything is okay and also to see how long the protection will last.
Now, listen, I know you don't have a crystal ball, but given what you already know about how antibodies work for other illnesses, what do you anticipate will be the outcome of the trial?
We are optimistic that it will work because everything we know about antibodies is that they work early on in infection, and we already have experience from over 100,000 people that have received plasma in the United States that it's a safe product and that if it's going to work, it's most likely going to work when given early and given in high enough concentration, which is exactly what we're doing, is giving it early and giving high concentration of antibody.
Now, I'm glad you mentioned early because everyone watching at home may know a relative of themselves. How do I enter this trial? What are the qualifications if someone wants to participate in the trial?
If they already have the infection, then we would like them to have symptoms for a week or so or less, because if they've already had symptoms for a couple of weeks, it's probably too late. On the other hand, if they've had an exposure, then we would like that exposure, the last exposure, to have happened within 5 days. So if somebody is at home and has a kid that came back from college and the kid is diagnosed as having an infection, it's 5 days from the last time that they were with the kid while he was having symptoms.